judges, teachers, and fellow students. My story is called A Day Push. This story takes place in Cuba, summer of 2009. One day, while in Cuba, my mom suggested us to go deep sea fishing. As we were leaving our hotel room, my dad invited our friends and told them to have a barbecue ready to grill the fish. As we entered the boat, the captain of the boat mentioned that there was going to be a contest that day. Of whoever got the biggest fish was going to win $100. So my dad bought tickets worth of $20, thinking that he was going to win. The boat ride was pleasant, but as we got to the deep sea area, it was very scary. The water was very agitated. The boat seemed unstable. It was going back and forth, back and forth, and a massive water was coming in. I thought the boat was going to be swallowed by all the waves. Then, my mom, panicking on my brother and brought us to closed areas of the boat, leaving my dad fishing because he was determined to catch that fish. We almost saw my dad catch a fish, but as he was pulling it in, it got stuck with the fishing rod of the guy beside him. All the mush about whose fish it was, they both lost it. The fish swam away happily. At the end of the boat ride, no one ended up winning the contest. And no one ended up catching a fish, all because of the agitated water. At that point, my mom remembered that my big mouth dad had invited our neighbors with fish that we were supposed to have caught. So my dad had an idea. He decided to stop at the fish market, buy a fish and we weren't too pleased with that idea, but we went along with it. Because when it comes to my dad, we have no choice. As we arrived at our hotel room, my dad and my neighbors were cleaning the fish. My dad was bragging on what a piece of cake it was, while my mom and I were rolling our eyes. Then, my little brother sternly came out of the pool, looked at the barbecue grill, and let the guy out of bed. He told my dad, "Daddy, are you sure this fish is big enough to feed all of us? I told you about the biggest fish there was." My neighbors looked at my dad, tapped him on the shoulders, and said, "Go catch him. We've never seen a better fish than this." Now, the moral of the story is not to lie to people. You end up getting caught. Thank you.
Tu dois épouser une leur de nous.
Non!
Il s'agit La terre tremble, les éclairs se mettent à pourfendre dans le ciel, et le sorcier, en un peu vieux, apparaît. Il fixe les géants du bois dans nos yeux. Les géants essaient de l'écraser avec leurs pieds, mais ils ne réussissent pas. Car le sorcier, la métamorphose, en un immense bloc de pierre sur le bord de la lumière. Je ne les détruis pas, dit le sorcier. Je les laisse réfléchir pour quelques milliers d'années. Ha 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 ha! Surtout, ne t'arrête jamais de chanter. Et il disparaît. Merci, vous savez un peu trop tard. Elle écouta. Son chant traversa les montagnes et guida son fiancé qui vient la sauver. Il vit heureux. Plus tard, les colons français et les chasseurs nommèrent cette rivière Sabina ou Saguenay. Et finalement, elle devient Saguenay. Vous connaissez sûrement le sablier à sèche. Mais ils ne savent toujours pas que les quatre rochers sur le bord de la rivière sont les quatre frères qui menaient les géants. Si vous y passez un jour, écoutez le vent, sifflez les mélodies de sable.
Watched it all off.